Welcome back. India thrashed Sri Lanka in the first one day international and they'd also look to win the second game and take the ODI series as well. Well, if you are a cricket lover, well, I think we're all a cricket lovers watching this video, we're having a blockbuster week because we've literally seen 10 international teams competing each other in a single day all around the globe. We're having India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, England, South Africa and Ireland, Zimbabwe, Bangladesh and finally Australia and West Indies. So this is the first time that 5 international matches have been played in a single day since the pandemic in 2020. Let's talk about the India-Sri Lanka series. Sri Lanka's captain Dasun Shanaka won the toss and elected to bat first in a good batting wicket. All the Sri Lankan batsmen from 1 to 8 got starts, but no one made a 50, and that was the difference between 260 and 300. Considering the pitch condition and the Indian batting lineup, 260 was always under par. And that's what happened. Prithvi Shah started brilliantly, continued by the debutant Ishan Kishan, and finished brilliantly by another debutant Surya Kumar Yadav. Ishan Kishan became the second Indian to score a 50 on his birthday and on his debut. He started off scoring with a 6 and he became the second batsman in the world to score a 50 in the T20 International and the ODI International on debut. What about India's bowling? They had a decent outing except Bhuvneshwar Kumar. His economy was more than 7 from the 9 overs that he bowled, and once again India failed to pick up a wicket in the first 10 overs. Thank God that Kuldeep Yadav and Yuzvendra Chahal picked up 2 wickets. Kuldeep Yadav picked up 2 wickets in just 1 over and Chahal picked up a wicket right from his first delivery. An economical spell from Kunal Pandya's best ODI figures, 1 for 26 from 10 overs, and Hardik Pandya got a wicket and even Deepak Chahar picked up 2 wickets. The Sri Lankan bowling effort was so ordinary. Except Dushmanta Chamira, no one bowled more than 140 kilometers. Well, Isuru Dana, who has the capability to do that, but he did not do that. He was always on the defensive side to Prithvi Shah. The spinners, Sri Lanka do lack a proper off-spinner. They have 2 leg spinners, the right-arm leg spinner Wahindu Asaranga and the left-arm leg spinner Lakshan Sandagan. Well, if the wicket is not turning, you have to control your line and length. Generally, the leg spinners will always find it difficult to control the line and length. At that moment, you need an off-spinner, a proper off-spinner. Well, you can say Ishan Kishan batted well and Prithvi Shah and Surya Kumar batted well, but it was the captain, Shikhar Dhawan, who scored 86 not out, hit the winning runs and made a captain's knock in his first ODI as captain. Well, for the rest of the 2 ODIs, I don't think India will make any changes, except they'll go with Sanju Samson for Manish Pandey and Nadeep Saini for Bhuvneshwar Kumar if they fail to perform in the second ODI. As far as Sri Lanka is concerned, they have a lot of things to be changed. They need a proper off-spinner, a right-arm off-spinner, because India have two left-arm batsmen in their top order, well, Ishan Kishan and Shikhar Dhawan, so Sri Lanka need a proper right-arm off-spinner. Now, we'll just travel from Sri Lanka to Ireland to witness one of the greatest ODI series in Ireland cricketing history. I'm just so sorry that I did not cover the ODI series, but I've written articles based on the 3-match one-day series and I've given the link in my description. You can check it out. Ireland won their first one-day international against South Africa for the first time. They won it by 76 runs in the second ODI, where the first ODI was washed out due to rain. And South Africa made a comeback by winning third ODI by 70 runs. South Africa posted a mammoth 346 runs in the first innings thanks to Jamin Malan's record-breaking innings. He scored 177 runs from just 169 balls. He scored the 5th highest score by a South African batsman in ODI cricket and he faced the 3rd most number of deliveries by a batsman in ODI cricket. And South Africa won the 3rd match and levelled the series 1-1. Now the T20s. This was the first time that Ireland and South Africa met each other in a T20. South Africa batted first and no one got a 50. Well, Rabada's 4 consecutive boundaries caught them past 150 and they scored 165 runs in their allotted 20 overs. But the Irish batsmen were never in the chase. World's number 1 T20I bowler W. S. Shamsi picked up 4 wickets and 2 wickets apiece for Lungi Ngidi and George Linder, made it even more difficult for the Irish batsmen. But the late order flourish from their bowlers made sure that they were closer to the target but not closer enough. So in the end, South Africa won the first T20 International by 32 runs and there is still 2 more matches to go and we're exciting a cracker of a contest. If you like this video, please share and subscribe and click the bell icon to receive all notifications from Cricket Pundit.